15 super talented wrestlers whose careers were destroyed by Vince McMahon. Originally starting off as a show where up-and-coming talent could showcase their abilities in an attempt to get a contract with the WWE, NXT eventually became a promotion on its own for rising talent, and it's quickly become a force in the wrestling industry. A huge number of today's current superstars made their way through the NXT ranks, and the NXT roster, in its current state, remains stacked full of budding talent. We've seen so many wrestlers come up into the WWE from NXT and make a huge impression on fans from the get-go, but unfortunately, some wrestlers have struggled to find any sort of footing after being called to the main roster. The names on this list are comprised of those wrestlers who had all the promise in the world but have yet to do anything with their immense amount of talent. Whether they're dealing with injuries or a lack of a major push from the powers that be, these superstars have yet to achieve what many fans felt they were destined for. These performers were once red-hot prospects but have since become an afterthought in the minds of fans. Of course, there's always time in a person's career for him or her to make a comeback, so we remain hopeful that, one day, these 15 performers will eventually find the success that we all expected them to gain. Until then, though, they'll remain on this list as some of the biggest NXT call-ups who were squashed by Vince McMahon. 9. Bo Dallas. Seth Rollins, Big E, Neville, Kevin Owens, Finn Balor, Samoa Joe, and Shinsuke Nakamura have all been NXT champions who've gone on to do incredible things on the WWE main roster. With such a prestigious group of names, looking through the history of the belt might leave some confused to see the name Bo Dallas appear. Nevertheless, during his time in NXT, Bo Dallas was long considered the next big thing in wrestling, and his time on the main roster has been almost embarrassing to watch. He's an incredibly talented performer who's been given one of the most annoying gimmicks to watch on television. Things simply haven't panned out for the talented wrestler, and he's currently playing second fiddle to The Miz, along with Curtis Axel. Maybe Bo Dallas will achieve the level of success that many had anticipated, but for now, we can't help but wonder what could've been for this superstar. 10. The Vaudevillains. It's hard to imagine that the gimmick of the Vaudevillains was going to have a huge impact on the WWE main roster, but they were popular enough on NXT to generate some buzz. Then they finally got the call-up. Comprised of wrestlers Simon Gotch and Aiden English, the Vaudevillains produced one of the more unique gimmicks in recent tag team memory, and there was enough skill between the two of them to make them a potential force on the main roster. Unfortunately, the Vaudevillains were a massive flop in the WWE, and Simon Gotch has since returned to the independent wrestling scene to perform under the ring name Simon Rum. Aiden English still remains on the main roster, and we're curious to see what's going to end up happening with his character in the long run. Hopefully, he'll be able to achieve more success than he had during his partnering with Simon Gotch. 11. Bayley. How is it possible that at this point in her career, Bayley hasn't completely taken over the WWE Women's Division? In her NXT days, Bayley was not only a fan favorite but was also one of the most talented performers on the overall roster. Don't believe us? Just go ahead and re-watch her match with Sasha Banks from NXT TakeOver Brooklyn, where the duo put on arguably one of the top wrestling matches of the year. Expectations were at an all-time high when Bayley finally made her way into the WWE, and at every turn, the company seems to have done everything in its power to negatively impact her career. She dropped the belt to Alexa Bliss at her hometown of San Jose, California, and things haven't looked good for her ever since. She's currently recovering from an injury, and people are hopeful that upon her return, she'll receive the push that she'd been due for a very long time. 12. Lana. As a manager playing the love interest of her real-life husband Rusev, Lana quickly became a fan favorite within the WWE universe. She's a beautiful woman who played the heel manager role to perfection, not unlike Sunny had done a few decades ago. Recently, The company elected to give her a push as a wrestler, and needless to say, things haven't gone according to plan for the young lady. Each match that she participated in has effectively been a squash match, and she's shown that she could use plenty more time to harness her skills inside the ring. Unfortunately, because her matches have gone so poorly, the WWE Universe has very little interest in seeing her perform as a wrestler again and would much prefer to see her back as the heel manager for her husband, Rusev. Rumors have swirled recently that the duo is looking to exit the company, but hopefully, this isn't the case, as they possess great talent, especially when paired together. 13. Tyler Breeze. While you could argue that his gimmick is more of a been there done that type of deal, you have to give Tyler Breeze some credit because back in his NXT days, he was a very popular performer, and many people were eagerly anticipating his call up to the main roster. Unfortunately, as a solo performer, Breeze has done next to nothing during his time in the WWE, and had it not been for a recent resurgence with teammate Fandango, he could easily be considered one of the biggest busts in the company's history. The team of Breezango has done an excellent job in providing comedic relief when they get the opportunity to appear in front of the camera, but we can't help but wonder what would have happened had Breeze received the proper push upon his arrival into the WWE. Hopefully, one day, this talented performer will get a second opportunity to prove himself as a talented singles performer. 14. Curtis Axel. As the son of wrestler Kurt Hennig, better known by his ring name, Mr. Perfect, you'd expect a next-generation superstar like Curtis Axel to receive an incredible push during his time in the WWE, but alas, this hasn't been the case for the stars. For whatever reason, be it the company's untimely decisions for his booking or their lack of faith in Axel as a performer, it seems that his talents have completely gone to waste inside of the company. While you could argue that being a one-time WWE Tag Team Champion and a one-time WWE Intercontinental Champion would be enough to say you've had a successful career, in the grand scheme of things, Curtis Axel has been little more than a blip on the radar. He's currently playing second fiddle to The Miz along with fellow wrestler Bo Dallas, who will no doubt make an appearance later on this list. While he seems to be a great company guy, perhaps Axel would be best off finding work in another promotion like Ring of Honor or New Japan Pro Wrestling. 15. Eric Rowan. Considering all of the success that each member of the Wyatt family has achieved during their time in the WWE, you really have to feel bad for Eric Rowan. Obviously, Bray Wyatt has been the most successful, eventually winning the WWE Heavyweight Championship, and Luke Harper has done very well for himself as well. Braun Strowman looks to be the next big thing, and Randy Orton's short time with the Wyatt family, while seemingly odd at the time, further added to the fact that the members of the family have had very successful careers so far. Then, there's the case of wrestler Eric Rowan. Rowan was a one-time WWE NXT Tag Team Champion with Wyatt family member Luke Harper, but his time on the main roster has been an incredible disappointment in comparison to his brothers. So far, his biggest career achievement is winning the Slammy Award for Match of the Year, but this came in a team versus team match in 2014 and not as a singles competitor. There's still time for Rowan to receive a solid push, and we're hoping that he isn't completely buried